Thank you for joining me today to learn about RBC Express's Cheque-Pro services. This video is part 2 of a 3-part series. In this video, we'll be taking a look at how to set up your Cheque-Pro scanner. Before you begin the driver download for Cheque-Pro, you may want to pull your cheque scanner out of the box to identify the make and model. However, we recommend downloading the drivers from RBC Express before you plug the device into your computer. RBC does not support any one check scanner model over the other. However, these devices typically come with the following common elements: a cord to connect to power, a cord for connecting to your computer, typically a standard USB cord. On the device itself, there should be a light. This is typically lit only when the device is connected. The device will also come with its own drivers. These typically download when the device is plugged in for the first time. This is why we recommend completing the driver download before plugging the device into your computer. However, it will work if it's already been plugged in. The Cheque-Pro service can be accessed from the Payments, Transfers, and Deposits tab on the blue banner at the top of your screen. To enter Cheque-Pro, you would click on the Deposit and Manage Checks link. When you enter Cheque-Pro for the first time, you should receive a prompt like this one. This is asking if I need to download the drivers, and if I'm ready to download, I can leave the first option selected and continue. If you have previously missed this prompt, you can also initiate a driver download by going to the homepage of Cheque-Pro and select the blue button on the right that says Create New Deposit. In the next video in this series, on how to create a deposit, we will review this screen in detail. For downloading a driver, the only thing that needs to be done here is to enter $1 into the declared amount field. And now you can see the same prompt. I'm leaving option 1 selected and choosing continue at the bottom of the page. The next page presents you with a list of check scanners that can be used for RBC accounts. Select your model and watch for your browser to alert you to a download. This may happen at either the top or bottom of your screen. When prompted, select Run and follow your computer's prompt to complete the download. Your organization may require the computer administrator password. You may want to consult your IT before beginning the download. During the download, you will be prompted to plug the scanner in and power it on. Once the driver download is complete, we recommend that you open the drivers to test them. Opening the drivers can also be done in future if you need to troubleshoot scanner connectivity issues. Go to the Start menu of your computer and view the list of programs. The drivers are called Passport, Web Edition, Client. When you click on the drivers, there will be multiple options. Begin by selecting Restart Web Client Drivers. When you click this option, it may seem like nothing is happening. This is normal. The driver restart is happening in the background. Next, we will select Web Client Diagnostics. This will open a web page. Some browsers may ask you additional security questions before displaying the web page. On the diagnostic page, you just want to click Initialize Scanner. There are two possible results from the diagnostic tool. The first is status success. This means the drivers are working and they're able to connect to the physical scanner. The other result is transport off. This means the drivers cannot connect to the physical scanner. You may need to check that your scanner light is on and that it's plugged into power and into the computer. Once your drivers are downloaded, you can begin to make deposits. Watch video number 3 on how to make deposits and save reports in Cheque-Pro. If you are an administrator on RBC Express and you would like to set up a user to have access to Cheque-Pro, you can watch video number 1 in our series. If you have any questions about the features shown in this video, you can always contact the Client Support Center. Our phone number is at the bottom of your screen at all times.